IEEE 754. What is it and why does it break the math? Spoiler, it doesn't. And let's find out why. So imagine that you are writing some JavaScript code and need to perform a few calculations. Everything works perfectly well while you are dealing with integers. But the moment you introduce decimal numbers, suddenly logic goes out of the window. So here you are, ready to blame JavaScript for yet another inconsistency. But the trick is that if you try to do it in any other programming language, most likely you will get similar results. Why is that? Well, it all comes down to the way computers work with data. As we all know, they are able to differentiate only two states, on and off, which results in binary format with just two values, 0 and 1. When it comes to integers, there are no problems. We can represent any of them given that we have enough bits. To convert number from decimal format to binary, we can use simple technique of repeatedly dividing that number by 2, writing down the remainder each time. Let's take number 25 for example. Divide it by 2, and we get 12 with the remainder equal to 1. Now divide 12 by 2, and we get 6 with the remainder 0. Repeat the process till the end, and read the reminders from bottom to top. This is our binary representation. If we want to convert it back to decimal, we can use another method where we assume that each bit represents the next power of 2 starting from 0. So the first bit is 1, second is 2, third one is 4, and so on. Now we just sum up all values where bit is equal to 1. Okay, but what about fractions? Well, with integers we start with 2 to the power of 0 and then increase the power. In fractions, we decrease it. So the first bit is 2 to the power of minus 1, which is 1 half. Second is 2 to the power of minus 2, which is 1 quarter, and so on. This is called fixed point notation. You have a certain amount of bits on left, representing the integer part, and certain amount of bits on the right, representing the fractional part. Some fractions, like 0.75, can be easily represented in binary, while some, well, not so much. Take for example 0.8. There is no combination which would give the exact number we wish to present. It is easier to see in decimal to binary conversion. In case of integers, we were dividing the number by 2 and writing down the remainder. In case of fractions, we multiply the number by 2. During each step, the integer part represents the individual bit. Then we take the fractional part and multiply it again. We repeat the process until we reach 1.0. Let's take a look. Here we have our 0.8125. Multiply it by 2 and we get 1.625. Take fractional part and multiply it by 2 as well. Repeat the process and eventually we reach 1.0 and get our binary representation of the number. But in case of 0.8, we have a problem. 0.8 times 2 is 1.6. Let's take fractional part and multiply it by 2 and we get 1.2. 0.2 times 2 is 0.4 and 0.4 times 2 is 0.8. As you can see, we got ourselves a nice endless cycle.
Ah, shit. Here we go again.
But before you blame those stupid machines, think about it for a moment. We humans have the similar problem. What if I ask you what is 1/3 in decimal? Well, it's 0.3 repeating infinitely. We can write it as 0.3, but we can never fully capture its true value. Computers face the same issue. They don't have infinite amount of space, so they have to approximate. And that's where IEEE 754 comes in. It is a clever standard that allows to represent very large and very small numbers as accurate as possible. The key idea behind it is scientific notation, where instead of storing every digit explicitly, we break down the number into two parts, mantissa, which holds the significant digits, and exponent, which determines where the decimal point should be placed. The system allows the decimal point to float, dynamically adjusting to represent a vast range of values, hence the name, floating point. There are two main variations, 32-bit single precision and 64-bit double precision. In many programming languages, float type represents single precision and double, well, double precision. The only difference between them is the amount of bits you have, but the formula is the same. Reserve one bit to identify whether the number is positive, represented by 0, or negative, represented by 1. Then 8 or 11 bits for exponent, and finally 23 or 52 bits for the mantissa. So, what 0.8 would look like in this format? Well, first part is easy, the number is positive, so we assign 0. Exponent and mantissa, though, are a bit tricky. First, we need to get binary representation of 0.8 using fixed point notation. Then we need to move the floating point to left or right, so we end up with only one single bit with value 1 on the left side of the point. In our case, we can move point one step to the left, which results in exponent being minus 1. Now the tricky part, we need to add 127 to our exponent, which results in 126, and binary representation of 126 is our true exponent. The reason for that is that we use 8 bits to represent the exponent, which means that the biggest number we can get is 255 and the smallest is 0. But we don't want to have only positive exponents, we also want to have negative ones, just like we have in our case. That's why there is a rule. We take 127 as the middle value and treat it as a true zero. Everything below it is negative, and everything above it is positive. Hence the offset which we have to apply. Okay, now in Mantissa part there is also a small trick. Remember how we moved the point so only one non-zero bit on the left is present? Now we can drop this one, since we know that it's always gonna be there, and store the fractional part in the Mantissa, which means that we also have one additional bit of precision to store at the end. And here we have it, binary representation of 0.8 in IEEE 754 format. But, despite the fact that this standard is extremely efficient, it doesn't solve the fundamental problem that some numbers cannot be properly represented in binary format. And so this standard is also forced to approximate when it deals with those infinitely repeating numbers. But, you have to admit, this thing, despite being ugly, is pretty close to the truth. That's why this standard is used in all of modern computing and can be mistakenly treated as the source of this weird behavior, while in reality, the true cause lies in the nature of the binary format. Okay, but while those approximations are acceptable in some simple day-to-day operations, it is absolutely not in some serious matters, like banking.
This is unacceptable!
That's why many programming languages include decimal type, which reduces rounding errors by storing numbers in base 10 rather than binary. This helps to avoid unexpected floating point inaccuracies, but it comes at the cost of slower performance due to the additional processing required for conversions and arithmetic operations. Well, I hope that this video helped you to understand how floating point numbers work in binary. If you enjoyed the video, please leave a like, a comment, and of course subscribe for more. Bye!